Hello and welcome back to Gurukul Online Learning. I hope you're doing well. And I also hope that by this time you have been able to figure out how to play the composition that we just learned, how to play and infuse it into the beat cycle, the 16 beat cycle that we also went through the last class, which is called Kintal. So in this lesson, what we are going to do is we are going to learn how to set the triplets that we have been learning and saving up for this day to learn how to infuse them inside our composition. So before we do that, I'd like to kind of go over something that we have already went over, but we are going to do it again just for your ease of understanding. How do we count tans? So before that, the first and foremost thing that needs to be specified is the tempo. So we've agreed to use 90 BPM as our standard tempo for learning the composition that we are learning. And that tempo is kind of like dha, dhin, dhin, dha, dha, dhin, dhin, dha. So every stroke of the tabla is going to represent a beat. So dha, din, din. This is your tempo. If we count it, we are going to count it in exactly the same tempo. Na, titte, din, din, dha. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You get the idea. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So one thing you need to remember about tans are they are always going to be presented at double the speed of the original tempo that you're playing in your composition. So if this is your original tempo, the tan is going to be exactly double that. So original, double. So the smaller tans that we have, the first three were supposed to be there were supposed to be 8 matra or 8 beat tans. So how do we count 8 beats? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Dha, dhin, dhin, dha, dha, dhin, dhin, dha. Having that said, if you're going to sing the tans, so since it's going to be double, so every stroke here is going to equate to 2 strokes on the tan since it's double. So dha, dhin, dhin, dha, dha, dhin. Now for the tan, dha. Sa re ga ma pa da ni sa sa ni da pa ma ga re sa sa re ga ma pa da ni sa sa ni da pa ma ga re sa 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 So I'm hoping that you got the idea. I'm going to play all the tans if you want to, for example, if we want to play the next tan, which was ga ma la ni sa ni da pa ma ga pa ma ga re sa ni. So dha dhin dhin dha, your original tempo, and the tan dha dhin dhin na dha. So something like that. So I'm gonna play without the tabla once and then with the tabla again, just to make you understand. So the pandish. Three 8-beat tans. Now for the bigger one. So the bigger one was ni re ga ma pa ma ga re ga ma ga ni sa ni da pa ni re ga ma pa ma ga re sa ni da pa ma ga re sa. So that is going to be of 16 beats because it's exactly double than the tan that we played, which was originally 8 beats. So how do we count that? So 16 beats, since it's double, you don't really need let me count. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Ni re ga ma pa ma ga re ga ma da ni sa ni da pa. Ni re ga ma pa ma ga re sa ni da pa ma ga re sa. And that gives you 16. So there are 32 strokes in a 16 beat tan or triplet, and there are 16 strokes in an 8 beat tan, because the tempo of the tan is always going to be double than the tempo of your original. So you see, we have already done multiplication and division, and slowly and steadily we're going to involve more and more math, which can get complex and fun at the same time as we develop. So we're going to try and use the tabla to kind of fuse this together. This is a trial version, so it's going to keep on stopping, but I hope you get the general idea. So we're going to start with interesting thing is, we also have to learn where do we, because every time you finish a tan, your idea should be that every time you finish the tan, you have the very next beat is gonna be sum. This is the target for now. You finish a tan, and just as you're finished, your sum is going to be, the first beat is going to be right there when you're finished. So it's important to know where you're gonna start these tans from. So I'm gonna play for a while and then explain how I did it. So if you notice that every time I played, it came back to sum. How am I gonna do that? So I picked the first half, as I already told you, that teen tal, every time signature, even beat cycle, we're gonna divide it with two, and we're gonna have the top, in this case, the top eight and the bottom eight. So I'm gonna spend the top eight, the first half of teen tal, in playing the bandish in terms of eight beat cycle tans. And then the second half of the tal, we are going to use to play the tal. So as I already mentioned, that 8-beat cycle tan is going to need 8 beats of your tempo, 8 beats. So if you spend the first 8 in playing the bandish itself, the second 8 is right there for you to play something which is going to fit in 8 beats. And when you're done with that cycle, you have the first beat again. So dha dhin dhin dha dhin dhin dha, and then this bar is complete, and then you have the second bar, which is the other 8. So you play just at the double speed, sa re ga ma pa ga ni sa sa ni la pa ma ga re sa. So as a visual representation, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 sa re ga ma pa ga ni sa sa ni la pa ma ga re sa da 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 da. So just to break it down, we are starting every 8 beat tan on khali, which is the first beat of the second half, which is number 9. So that being done, so we are now gonna start to identify the khali better and be able to pick the tan up right from there. We're gonna use all three tans. The idea is to remember where, to understand and pick up where the Kali is. So, 5, 6, 7, 8. Second down. 5, 6, 7, 8. Again. So I'm hoping that you're getting the general idea. So what I'm going to do, this is something still that you're going to need to practice a lot to get right. But again, I'm going to do, just for your ease of understanding, I'm going to play all three tans, starting from Kali, which is exactly on number 9. And it should be good. And later, we are also going to try out the 16 beat cycle. So, in, ha, ha, in, ha. We are, of course, we are left with the fourth and the bigger tan, but I think that should wait just for a while, because sometimes you have way too much information cramped into your head and it's gonna lead to confusion, which we don't want. So you're gonna have, for today, you're gonna have to get your tabla and you're gonna have to try and make it very natural for you to be able to understand which is called sam and which is called kali, and then play. So pointers, 8 matra or 8 beat tans are always going to start from number 9. The number 9th beat, which we know as Kali. And it's always, the tan is always going to be double the speed of your original tempo. And you understand this and practice and you should be perfect. Thank you for your attention in class. I hope that it's helping you all. We will meet again on the next class. Bye bye.